Hi everyone, in this video, we are going to talk about normality. So as you may already know, normality is a very important condition in many statistical methods. For example, in two sample t-tests, we assume the two populations are from normal distribution. So, in linear regression models, we assume the residues follow a normal distribution as well. So this is a data example that I'm going to show you how to check normality condition. The first tool we are going to talk about is called histogram. The second one is called QQ plot. And the third one is a test, which is shapiro-wilk test, which is a normality test. So the first two are kind of visualization of the data, and the histogram is very subjective because one may comment the histogram looks normal and another may comment, okay, it's right skewed. For QQ plot, it's less subjective because you do have a reference line. But for the shapiro-wilk test, you kind of get the test statistic, which means you would be more comfortable making conclusions. So let's run. I have typed the size here, a size data set. So you can see it has 30 observations. So the first tool I'm going to use is to just draw a quick and simple histogram. And you can run that. And the histogram is popped up on the right side. You can zoom the picture and you can see this is kind of a nice histogram. It's a little right skewed, but roughly and for real data, it's kind of normal. So the second graph, you can actually describe histograms through whether it is skewed or symmetric. You can also describe a histogram according to the modality it has. And then you can also describe if it has outliers from the histogram you are seeing. The second tool is called QQ plot, which is drawn using QQ norm. So QQ plot is a quantile-quantile plot. So as you can see, I just ran QQ norm on size. I actually have the sample quantiles on the y-axis, and I have theoretical quantiles on the x-axis. So theoretical quantiles means the quantiles from a standard normal distribution. So you are actually checking how does the quantiles match with a theoretical, with a perfect normal distribution. And another thing you wanted to add into it is called QQ line. So if you run that QQ line, it will add a reference line to the graph so that you can see how close all the dots are to the reference line. So if the dots are hanging tightly around that reference line, that means you are assuming that the sample data is from a normal distribution. So from this example, the top right corner is a little off, but mostly is around that reference line. So we would not worry about the normal normality condition at this point. So the third tool is called, let me make a note here. So we want all the dots hang tight around the reference line. So that's what we want. It's less subjective because you do have a reference line to tell, right? To tell is there a big difference or they are far away from the line. So the last tool we are going to use is a test. So you are actually telling the significance, like how close or how significant the size data is to a normal distribution. So we just type the name of the test like this, and you choose the second one, and you put the size data in there. So you can see every time you do a normality check, it must be on a list of numbers. So you cannot do the test or draw a graph on a whole data set, right? So our size data is a list of observations, and we run the histogram, the QQ plot, or we do the test on that list of observations. So you can see the test result is very simple. It's a normality test. It is testing whether the data is from a normal distribution or not. So you can think of the null hypothesis is that the data is from a normal population. And the alternative hypothesis here is actually saying that the data is not from a normal distribution. So these are the tests or the statements we are checking on. And from the p-value, so you know p-value is a significance level, like you actually use p-value to make your decision on a test, right? So the p-value here is very large, which means we would not reject the null hypothesis. Or we can think of we don't have enough data to reject this statement here. So that also means we can assume our data is from a normal distribution, or we would not reject, we would not conclude that the data is not from a normal distribution. So all three of these are the methods to check the normality condition. So one is a graphic tool that is known to most people, and the QQ norm is a little higher level, but it's less subjective because you have the reference line. And the last one is actually a test, which is not subjective at all because you do have your p-value to make your decision on which statement is you're checking, concluding on which statement. So that's about it for checking normality.